until you hit 10,000 hours in my mind, don't make a DVD, don't write a book. Work. Perfect the craft. Get out and train people so that when you decide to do one and two, you will actually have something to contribute to the pile versus being in a situation where you just, you know, added to the junk on somebody's shelf. Which is, I think, unfortunately, too much of what we got. You know, in the last, I said, the last 10 years, the explosion of this internet age, you know, you get stuff and you're like, wow, $70 worth of overpriced crap. You know, that I just paid, you know, say, I sell an e-book, or I actually give away the e-book now on my website. But it's there. I mean, it's the best thing in the world. E-books, hey, you know, Ryan Lee's like, e-books are great. If you can get people to buy e-books, you should sell them e-books. Because they don't cost anything. You know, there's no production cost. There's nothing involved. But it's amazing. I can't tell you the number of e-books I've seen where I'm like, gee, this isn't very good. If you want to be a writer on internet marketing, be a writer on internet marketing. But don't call yourself a fitness person. You know, if you want to be a fitness person, then you have an obligation to distribute quality information that somebody's going to want to read, that somebody's going to want to recommend, and not that's sold because your sales copy is good. The reason I know Pat, Nick, and Jim, and these guys, the reason I know Ryan, is their stuff is good, their stuff helps. The reason I've seen some other stuff and I'm like, ooh, you know, not very good, but it's amazing what a sales letter, a good sales letter, and I won't lie, somebody's probably going to talk about sales letters today. A good sales letter is invaluable because it will make somebody buy something they neither want or need. So in some ways, that's all right. Read first, write second. First, read to gain a knowledge base. You cannot read too much. There is no possible way that you can even read enough. I don't think most of us do nearly enough reading. It's amazing when you ask people about books and what books they've read, whether it's from a personal development standpoint or from a professional standpoint. The interesting thing that I know, the people that are the best read are usually doing the best. You know, like Alan Cosgrove reads, like he has no kids, so he's well, kind of reading. He reads 2 or 3 books a week. I start 2 or 3 books a week, and then I keep piles around my house because I have really bad attention deficit disorder. I've realized that I've got a whole week. But, really good. Like, I probably have 8 books in my house right now that I'm partially reading. It's not a good way to read. But take lots of notes when you do it. File the notes away in your computer. Because the one thing, when you do decide to write something, you'll be amazed. First, when I wrote Functional Training for Sports is up in the back up there. When I wrote that book, Human Kinetics sent me a thing and said, do you want to write a book on functional training? And I was like, yeah, maybe I do. I'd always thought I wanted to write a book. I guess it just takes somebody asking me to actually do it that kind of got me off my ass. But I realized I had 27,000 words already written when I started pulling all these documents together from all over the place. Other things I had written, little manuals, little descriptions. So it was much easier to write because all this stuff was already written down. I had already read. I had already taken notes. You know, all the stuff I was doing was eventually going to become something. I just didn't know it at the time. Then write your impressions of what you read. Martin Rooney said this one time. It was really interesting. I stole this whole thought process really from Martin because he said you should read as much as you can. Then once you've read it all, then you should start writing down what you think about what you read. And then third, start writing down your original ideas. And it was one of those, it was a really good thing. I was very defined. It was like, okay, read as much as you can. Don't worry about it. Just get a lot of information. Throw a lot of stuff in the hard drive. You know, put as many files in as you possibly can. Then once you get them in there, then start scribbling down. What do you think? Was that junk? Was that a good idea? Does this work? Does this not work? Because you can take all this stuff. You know, I always just take it and throw it at some athletes, okay? Let's see if this works. That's why people say, you don't like this. You know, I'm like, there's very little that I don't like that I haven't tried. You know, we were using